Hi, good morning, everybody, and welcome to another glorious Lord's Day Sunday, your second one of 2022, for Sunday, January the 9th of 2022. Today, we're back in the It's All About God video series with number 33. The last one was 32, which was on the 22nd of December. Today will be number 33. So, this is your first It's All About God series video of 2022. So, but today's title, this is episode 593, part 1, your Days of Praise, and we're going to be Forgotten by God. Forgotten by God? Question mark. That's the way it's listed. But we're beginning with Psalms 13, 1. And two. So if you're excited about the God series once again, smash that like button. How is one way that God could forget us? God can't forget us. But is there a hypothetical way that God can forget us? That's a very informative thinking question. Can God forget us? Hypothetically. Because I know he can. But hypothetically, I want to see some very informative answers. Come up with the hypothetical answers. Do that. Subscribe if you do. Turn on notifications and share that video and channel with your family and friends and help me reach that, at least get to the 25 subscriber mark by Saturday, which is six days away, which will be episode 600 for the Daily Devos. But without further ado, video 33 of the It's All About God series, Forgotten by God. Psalm 13 verses 1 and 2 says, "How long wilt thou forget me, O Lord, forever? How long wilt thou hide thy face from me? How long shall I take counsel in my soul, having sorrow in my heart daily? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me?" Those are all questions. So David expresses deep anguish in these two verses. The question, how long, is repeated with every increasing intensity. In poetry, this is called an anaphora. A-N-A-P-H-O-R-A, anaphora. David begins by asking Yahweh, "How long wilt thou forget me? Forever?" So if being eternally forgotten isn't discerning enough, the second question expresses despair in an unplumbed way. The hiding of Yahweh's face with a feeling of intimacy's loss. God's servant now argues from the eternal, unveiling the deep wounding effects in his inner soul as his enemy gloats over his proverbial dead body. Okay? In verse 3, David demands, in the Hebrew imperative, that Yahweh consider, hear, enlighten his eyes. The psalm that began in a hopeless cry now takes a dramatic 180-degree turn, viewing life through the divine lens of God's sovereignty. Verse 5 states, "But I have trusted in thy mercy, my heart shall rejoice in thy salvation." What changed? Absolutely nothing, except for David's view of sovereign Yahweh. So did God ever look away from God? Did God ever look away from David? Excuse me, misread that, misquoted myself. No, if you are in Christ, does God ever ignore his children? Absolutely not. But hypothetically, that was the question I asked at the beginning. Can God forget you, hypothetically? Now if you're not a Christian, he can forget you. So this psalm gives us permission to cry out to Yahweh, venting all our frustrations and petitions to him. Besides this, our Lord teaches us to cling tightly to the promises spelled out in his precious word, naming his amazing attributes of forgiveness and steadfast love. Amen. And furthermore, all of God's paths, even the troubled ones described in this psalm, are steadfast love to those who are protected under the precious wings of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let me see who. I can't remember who done this passage. Chas Morse. M-O-R-S-E. Morse. C-H-A-S. Chas Morse. He's the one that quoted that Devo. So like it says, did God ever look away from David? No. If you are in Christ, does God ever ignore his children? Absolutely not. But hypothetically, the question I asked at the beginning, hypothetically, can he forget us? It's just on another plane. Hypothetically, he can. But in actuality, he doesn't. Like it says, absolutely not. But that's just something I wanted to throw a wrench in the gear shaft to make you think. But coming up tomorrow, in another fantastic Monday, your second Monday of the new year, for Monday, January 10th, in episode 594, part one, we're gonna be talking about Abram the Called. A-B-R-A-M, which turns out to be Abraham. That was Abraham's name before he became Abraham. His name was Abram before he was Abraham. And then with his wife Sarah, her name was Sarai, S-A-R-A-I, something like that, Sarai. Yeah, it was S-A-R-A-I was the way it's spelled. And then after God changed Abraham's name, he changed Sarai's name to Sarah. He took the I and put an H there. That's how it was changed. So, but that's what we'll have tomorrow. Coming up in your afternoon video today, we're going to be washed in part two of episode 593. We're going to be washed from Dave Brennan, derived from Titus 3:3-7. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after probably 1:30, between 1:30 and 2 o'clock. She's about 1:45 is usually on the Sunday videos for the afternoon. Because I got this one comes out at 8, so I pushed that almost to 2 o'clock. And then the other one, your weekend turning point will be at 7. I don't change the turning point videos any. So Sunday to Friday, it's at 7 for the turning point. But on the weekend, part 2 is between 5 and 6 on Saturdays. And probably about 1:40, I think about 1:45 on Sundays, because I'm about middle ways of the morning and the evening ones. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that, like I said, at 1:45 today. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And peace out until later. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day Sunday morning, and come back again for when we'll find out when we are washed. And we'll see what that's all about. But until then.